सेशन 9 ऑफ मॉड्यूल 1 ऑफ फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट ऑफ फोर्थ सेमेस्टर बीबीए ऑफ मैंगलोर यूनिवर्सिटी। इन दिस सेशन वी शिल स्टडी अबाउट द फंक्शंस ऑफ फाइनेंस मैनेजर। द इंक्रीजिंग पेस ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, rise of large scale units, innovations in information processing techniques, intense competition all have increased the need for financial planning and control. In the present business context, a financial manager is expected to perform the following functions: financial forecasting and planning, acquiring of funds, investment of funds, valuation decisions, maintain proper liquidity, deciding capital structure, selecting a pattern of investment, proper cash management, implementing financial controls, and proper use of surplus or the excess funds. Financial forecasting and planning. A financial manager has to estimate the financial needs of a business. The amount of funds will be needed for purchasing fixed assets as well as meeting the working capital needs. Finance manager has to plan the funds needed in the future. The acquisition and application of funds is an important function of a finance manager. Acquisition of funds. There are different sources available for supplying funds. These sources may be shares, debentures, amount from financial institutions, and borrowings from commercial banks. The selection of appropriate source is a difficult task. This choice of a wrong source of funds may create difficulties in later stage. The pros and cons, problems and the benefits of various sources should be analyzed before making the final decision of getting or acquiring funds from a right source. Investment of funds. Now the funds acquired should be invested. The cost of acquiring funds and the returns should be compared. The channels which generate higher returns should be preferred. The objective of maximizing the profits will be achieved only when the funds are efficiently used. That is, the funds do not remain idle, but they are utilized at the right time and at the right place. A financial manager has to keep in mind the principles of safety and soundness while investing the funds. So, where the funds are to be invested, how the funds are acquired, and which are the returns, where the returns are higher, in those projects the funds need to be invested. Valuation decisions. A number of mergers and consolidations take place in the present competitive industrial world. A finance manager is supposed to assist management in making valuation decision. For this purpose, he should understand various methods of valuing shares and other assets so that correct valuation of the assets is arrived at. Maintain proper liquidity. Every concern is required to maintain liquidity for meeting its day-to-day needs. Cash is the best source for maintaining liquidity. It is required to purchase raw materials, pay the workers, meet other expenses. A finance manager is required to determine the need of liquid assets and then arrange liquid assets in such a way that there is no scarcity of funds. So to avoid shortage of funds, the amount, right amount in right quantities is to be arranged so that the funds do not go idle and even there is no shortage of fund to meet the day-to-day expenses. Deciding capital structure. Capital structure refers to the kind and proportion of different securities for raising funds. A decision about various sources of funds should be linked to the cost of raising those funds. Now, the different sources of funds, the proportion of different securities. So, what about the share of equity, preference, debentures, bonds, and other borrowings? If cost of raising funds is very high, then such sources may not be useful for long term. A decision about the kind of securities to be employed and the proportion in which these should be used is an important decision. This will influence the short term as well as the long term financial planning of an enterprise. Selecting a pattern of investment. When funds have been procured, then a decision about investment pattern is to be taken. The selection of an investment pattern is related to the use of funds. The decision-making techniques like capital budgeting, opportunity cost analysis may be applied in making decisions about capital expenditure. The principles of safety, profitability, and liquidity cannot be ignored. A balance should be struck even in these principles. Proper cash management. Cash may be required to purchase raw materials, to meet the wage expenses, to meet the day-to-day expenses. The usual sources of cash may be cash sales, collection of debt, or short-term arrangements with banks. Cash management should be such that neither there is shortage nor the cash is idle. Any shortage of cash will damage the creditworthiness of the enterprise. So, purchase of raw materials, payment to the creditors, wage bills, day-to-day expenses. And the sources are cash sales, collection from the debtors, and the amount from the bank. So this way the cash management is done. Implementing financial controls. Financial control devices generally used are return on investment, budgetary control, break-even analysis, cost control, ratio analysis, cost and internal audit. The use of various control techniques by the finance manager will help in evaluating the performance in various areas and take corrective measures whenever it is needed. So the financial manager should have knowledge on the techniques that are used to make a financial control decision. Proper use of surplus. Surplus is the excess fund after paying or meeting all the expenses. How to use the fund? A judicious use of surpluses is essential, and diversification or expansion plan, and also in protecting the interest of the shareholders. A finance manager should consider the influence of various factors such as trend of earning from the past, how the company is earning the profits, expected earnings of the enterprise in the future, market value of the shares of the company, need for funds for financing the future expansion, a judicious policy for distributing surplus will be essential for the growth of the enterprise, that is to maintain proper growth of the unit maybe in future. So the funds should not be misused, or wrong decisions should not be taken with regard to the funds investment or spending. References.